Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, I'm Anna and I'm a little bit spooky, and today we're doing the unpopular makeup opinion tag. We got a few spicy questions in this one, and this is also in collaboration with my friend here on YouTube, Miss Donna. I will have her channel linked below and in the eye. She is my new obsession here on the platform and on Instagram. And she is doing a video every single day this month, which is insane and amazing. I don't know how she's doing this. I really don't. I'm struggling with 3 videos a week sometimes. So yeah, today we're both going to be doing our unpopular makeup opinions. So if this interests you, just go ahead and keep on watching. But before you do, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment down below. Let me know some tag videos you would like to see me do. I'm kind of really into tag videos at the moment. Let's get comfy, let's get kind of casual, chill, and talk about some unpopular opinions. I just want to preface this video real quick with saying that you may not agree with my opinions. That's one of their unpopular opinions, and that is totally fine. If we all had the same opinion, this world would be so incredibly boring. That's what makes it fun, is that we are all different, we are all our own person, and we can have our own thoughts, opinions, and feelings towards things, and it is totally fine and okay. So yeah, with that being said, let's get into this video. Okay, so the first question in this tag is popular product you don't like, but everyone else does. Elf Poreless Putty Primer. I don't like it. I just don't. I don't know why. Well, yeah, I do know why. I think it it makes my skin look more textured, and I feel like it does the opposite of what it's supposed to do on my skin. I don't know. That's just me. It's just not for me. However, a product that is somewhat similar that I do love is the L'Oreal Magic Perfecting Base. I feel like that does what the Poreless Putty Primer claims to do, and I would recommend that one over the e.l.f. one. Question number 2 is popular makeup product or brand everyone hates but you love. I can't really think of a brand necessarily or so much as a product, but I did see like the NYX Born to Glow foundation or concealer didn't get like the best reviews, but I really love that concealer, so that would be the only product I can think of that isn't the most broadly popular product. Oh, and Subculture by ABH, by Anastasia Beverly Hills. That palette got shit on left and right on YouTube, but I freaking love that palette and I think it's beautiful and it is one of my favorite palettes. Number 3, makeup collab you didn't like or weren't interested in. To be honest with you, I just kind of don't care about makeup collabs that much. Putting an influencer's name next to a product isn't gonna make me more likely or less likely to buy it. It really just comes down to the product, if I want it or not. Like, the colors have to be there, the formula has to be there, the quality has to be there. There are, of course, collabs that I think are fantastic, and I'm really happy for the creators to have gotten to do the collabs. I think that is fantastic that that is a thing that can be done, but at the same time, it's not that much incentive to me to buy a product unless it is just somebody that I absolutely adore. That's not really, doesn't make much difference in whether I'm gonna buy a product or not. Sometimes there's like maybe a licensed palette with like, for example, the Hocus Pocus palette. I love Hocus Pocus, but not only that, the color story in that palette was a color story that I enjoy, so therefore I wanted it. If the color story had been something I didn't care about, I wouldn't have wanted the Hocus Pocus collection. It doesn't really make that much difference to me about who the collaborator is on the product. Like, I bought the I Love Sourie Through My Eyes palette from ColourPop. I didn't even know who she was when I bought the collab or the palette. I just thought the colors were beautiful. So I don't really care otherwise. I will say some collabs that I really don't like, though, are these little cheapy licensed ones with, like Makeup Revolution does them with, like, the Friends one and the Nightmare Before Christmas one. I think they look a lot like kids' makeup, if you will. There's a lot of, like, Morphe ones I just don't care about, but I don't really care about Morphe that much on the whole. So there's a few in there that I'm just kind of like, so there are a few that I'm just like, no, about those Makeup Revolution ones just because they look very cheap. It looks like they cut corners to cover the cost of the licensing, if that makes sense. Like, I feel like brands can do high quality makeup in collaboration with movies and other brands and create high quality stuff without cutting the corners. Like Milk Cosmetics has done with Beetlejuice, and ColourPop does with Disney and other entities like that, they've maintained their quality and they have contributed to the brand. It wasn't just something with the name of the movie slapped on it and like a picture. It was thoughtful and there was a lot of work went into it and there was a creative direction with it. It wasn't just something that looks like it should come out at Hot Topic, if that makes sense. A lot of licensed collabs look like those cheapy ones that you see in Forever 21 or like Hot Topic or something like that. Like they just, they don't feel like anybody gave a shit about it. It just feels like a cash grab. And I like when brands with good reputations and great products can collab with another entity such as a movie or a band or an influencer and create something meaningful and thoughtful and beautiful. Like, look at Raw Beauty Christie's collection. How freaking gorgeous is that? The amount of love that went into that. And then she did with another collab this year with, was it Pure, I think? Oh, I can't remember. But, and there was so much thought and love that went into that palette. It was the double-sided one. Lovely. And I see that is how you do a collab. Don't just, you know, take some shades and slap a logo on it. Jackie Aina's collab. That was one I absolutely adored with ABH. I think some influencers or beauty influencers really have a great eye for color and formula. Therefore, their collabs are fantastic, such as Jackie Aina's, Raw Beauty Christie's, I Love Sari, because they have really great taste and style and it comes through in the product. And that's what I would want to see. I don't want, I'm not into collabs. They're just a plastic compact with just their name written on it. That basically kind of sums that up. I want there to be a lot of thought and love put into the collabs. Otherwise, I just don't care about them in general. For the most part, a name or entity attached to something doesn't incentivize me that much to spend the money. Did that answer the question? Next question is popular beauty influencer you don't subscribe to. I would just say like just ballpark off the top of my head. It'd be like James Charles, Jeffree Star, Jaclyn Hill. Me, Laura, Nikita Dragon, does she do YouTube? I don't even know. A lot of the huge YouTubers that do beauty, I don't watch. And it's not that I don't appreciate them for their talent, for the most part. It's just more like I maybe don't feel like I have a lot in common with them, or I don't find their content interesting. I don't mean to be rude there or ugly. I'm just, there's a lot of content creators that I feel like are very cookie cutter, very, you know, same formula with their videos, the same perfect studio lighting, production team, management team, just this unattainable, insane, like celebrity lifestyle that I'm just not drawn to. So I'd say it's more of just a type of influencer that I don't subscribe to rather than individuals, because I do like enjoy Nikki Tutorials on the other hand. Absolutely love her. There's just it's maybe that whole like LA scene I'm just not into, I guess. I like creators who are down to earth, who are relatable, people who I feel like I could have a conversation with, have a cup of coffee with and get along, and we have similar interests and similar lifestyles. You know, I like people that don't flaunt their wealth and show off all their, you know, what, Gucci tracksuits all the time and that kind of stuff and push merch. I don't like that lifestyle or that vibe. I don't like the excessive, extravagant lifestyles, and it just doesn't appeal to me. It's not something that's going to interest me, and there's millions of people that will interest, so yeah, their content, it just may not be my cup of tea, but it can be someone else's cup of tea, and that's perfectly fine. It's just, you know, back in the day, of course, I watched Jaclyn Hill because she used to be relatable to me, and now I'm just kind of like, eh, whatever, you know? Every now and then I'll watch one of her videos if it looks interesting, but I'm not subscribed to her channel necessarily. It'll just come, you know, sometimes I recommend it and I'm like, oh, well, let's see what that's about. Same with James Charles. Like, I'm not subscribed to him, but occasionally there'll be a video that piques my interest. But there's tons of creators that are larger on the platform that I do absolutely love. Like, Taylor Wynn, for example. I just love her content. Mallory Brooke, Leanne Says, Arna Elaine, like I said, Nikki Tutorials, Jessica Braun, Jen Phelps, Raw Beauty Christie. These are people that I think you can, for one thing, see the passion and that they are doing something they love. And that also makes me more inclined to watch their content. I don't want to watch content that's very routine looking or like it's produced, heavily produced, or, you know, perfectly edited. And it's because at some point it just doesn't feel genuine anymore. It feels like a produced TV show. And that's not entertaining to me. That's not why I watch YouTube. If I want to, you know, watch content like that, I would watch E! Channel or Bravo. You know, I'd watch Real Housewives. I don't know. I just prefer a little bit more simple, I guess, chill vibes. I want to watch people that are closer in my age range, that live a lifestyle a little bit more like mine, where I can, when I watch their videos, I can get, like, recommendations on products that I'm gonna want, and lifestyle products. And I like to watch people that I feel like when I invest my time in them, I feel like I get something from it, because your time is your most valuable currency. And when you put that toward, you know, I feel like something should be special or give you something if you're going to invest that in someone. You know what I mean? So, like, I want to watch creators that make me feel good and enrich my life. Boy, that got deep, didn't it? Yeah, I don't want to, like, hate watch or not enjoy what I'm watching. Yeah, I prefer just very down-to-earth, chill vibes. And there's so many creators on this platform that there's definitely someone for everyone. And that's what's beautiful about YouTube, is how diverse the landscape is, and that there's something for everybody on here, and we can build these wonderful little communities. And that's what's special, and that's what I'd rather focus my energy and attention and time on, are people that I feel like create a nice community around their channel, and that just make you feel good. I like to watch content that makes me happy. Okay, and question number 5, popular steps you never do. Well, I don't bake anymore. I used to bake, and I started like watching Robert Welch, and he is so anti-powder. I'm not anti-powder, but I have kind of come to the realization that baking is maybe a bit excessive for me. I don't need to do it. My skin's not that oily, and does age you a little bit. Sure, it can look good like far back on camera, but in person, it looks very heavy. Yeah, so I definitely don't bake anymore. I never really cared for the carving out the jawline thing, like taking the ton of baking powder in your sponge and going under here. I don't think that looks that great. Some people it looks good on, and I'm like, man, it doesn't look good on me, so I just don't do that. I've tried, it makes my jaw look incredibly wide. I think that's probably the only thing I really don't do, like, makeup step wise. Otherwise, I'll happily spend 20 minutes perfecting my eyebrow hairs. To each their own with makeup. I have seen people that it looks absolutely beautiful on, so. And number 6, popular brands are products you don't support. This one could be a spicy question. I'm gonna keep it simple and just tell you Jeffree Star. Brutally honest, I don't think he's a good person. He's kind of a shitty person, and I think a lot of the whole, you know, send me your Cash App or your Venmo, whatever, is all just PR stunts, and I don't think there's anything genuine there. That is someone and a brand that I don't think is worthy of my time, energy, or money, so. All right, number 7, a trend that you have no interest in trying, all cream products. I cannot get into doing like a full face of just cream products. I have oily skin. It would not go well. It would not wear well. And I don't know, I don't like that many cream products. I'm fine with a cream contour here and there, or a cream blush, or a cream highlighter. I really like putty formula types of products, but I can't get behind like the cream or liquidy products, and that being your full face, cream, bronzer, everything, and not setting anything with powder. I can't. I like powder. I like radiant powders, but I like powder. I like my face to be set but radiant. I don't like to feel my makeup like I want it to be set. So yeah, I can't get into the cream products, or like the whole super minimalist Glossier vibe. That just comes down to personal preference though, and it just being to me a bit boring. Even though I watch creators who do that and I think it looks absolutely stunning on them, I truly just enjoy the whole ritual of doing the makeup and doing my soft gothic glam vibes. It's what I enjoy, so I would rather sit down, take the time and do that. I don't know, it's just too boring for me, and it's not something, I don't think I would enjoy that style of makeup on myself, but I do think it is beautiful on other people, and I'm so jealous of that. And last question is makeup products that were better in theory. I think all of us will probably have the same answer for this one, and it's the pizza cutter eyeliners. You know, the one on the little rolly thing that you would like roll on liquid eyeliner. That the idea was good. I see where they were going with it. And in theory, it sounds good, but it's just not practical. It doesn't work. I've never seen anybody get it to work. Another thing would be eyeliner stencils and brow stencils. I've never gotten things like that to work for me. I've tried. I think that it just, they never work out. Or any like those little brow stamps or eyeliner stamps. They never look good. Is there anybody that's actually like really worked for in real life and you're watching, let me know in the comments. It doesn't seem practical. Like, I get the idea behind it. It never seems to work. And magnetic lashes. You know, that might be an answer to another question of like something other people love and I hate, but or just have no interest in is the magnetic lashes. Like, I get the theory behind it. I think it's a cool idea. And I have seen some people give them to work with certain brands, but I've seen how much struggle it is to get to that point. And you know, I'm over here happy with my lash glue and lashes. I don't want to have to learn another new skill for some fake lashes, because they don't seem like they're worth it. Popular product you don't like, because I do feel like magnetic lashes are kind of popular. And I think the like the magnetic liner, like I would like to try it, but I don't see it working. I really don't. Like, I don't know. I'm just gonna stay with my lash glue and my Ardell's, okay? So yeah, that is the unpopular makeup opinion tag. Let me know if you have some of the same thoughts on makeup, or if you have different thoughts. Leave them down below in the comments. Let's talk about it, because having different opinions is what makes the world go around. And I think if we all thought the same thing, the world would be incredibly boring. Can you imagine? Just think about that. Think if we all had the exact same feelings about every product and every single thing, how boring makeup would be, how boring the world would be in general. There would be no innovation. You wouldn't get these new cool products. It would just be a very depressing world, I think. If you don't agree with one of my unpopular opinions, that is absolutely a-okay, and more power to you. So yeah, that's like totally cool, whatever. It's important to think for yourself and always be your own person. That is one of the most important things, I think, is to be authentic to yourself. So yeah, that is all for today. Thank you for hanging out and listening to me ramble on about makeup and some stuff. I hope I didn't get too salty sounding. I wasn't meaning to be. I will see you guys in the next one. Stay safe and stay spooky. Bye now.